हेलो, दिस इज़ मसूद अंसारी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी, APSM कॉलेज बरौनी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन एक्सपेरिमेंटल एंड नॉन एक्सपेरिमेंटल मेथड। बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग टू डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन दीज ग्रुप्स और दीज मेथड्स, आई वुड लाइक टू इंट्रोड्यूस वेरिएबल, बिकॉज एनी रिसर्चर हु इज इंटरेस्टेड टू कंडक्ट एनी स्टडी, ही विल सेलेक्ट वन ऑफ द डिफरेंट फिनोमिना और वेरिएबल्स। सो व्हाट इज वेरिएबल? वेरिएबल इज एन स्टिमुलस or phenomena that varies and can be measured. So what can be the example of variable? Suppose the pen we have, is it variable? Can we say that pen is a variable? No, we can't say, because pen itself is not a variable, or any stimulus itself is not a variable, but attributes of that particular stimulus is a variable. So pen is not a variable, but its shapes, sizes, color are the variables. Another example, the room in which you are sitting, is it a variable? No, that is not a variable. Then what is the variable? The size of the room is variable. Room itself is not a variable. There are different kind of individuals, there are different caste of the individual, their creed of the individual. So are these variables? Yes, their caste, creed, color are the variables, but that individual itself is not a variable. Similarly, intelligence level, high, moderate, low, these are the variables. So variable is any event or stimulus that varies and can be measured. Now come to the next point, that is experimental method. There are four points to be noted in the experimental method. Experiments are generally conducted to establish cause and effect relationship. This is first point. What is second point? Second point is, experiments always take place in controlled condition. It means there must be some manipulation, some control on the variables. And third point is, it is a carefully regulated procedure in which changes are made in one factor and its effect is studied on another factor. Here is the two types of variables we can say. First one is independent variable and second is dependent variable. So in the experiment, researcher manipulate to the independent variable to see the influence of independent variable on the dependent variable. And fourth point is keeping other related factors constant. It means researcher will make those variables constant in which he is or she is not interested, or in which he is not interested to measure. So those variables, we can say extraneous variable, which may influence the dependent variable. So such kinds of variable researcher will control and constant them, so that they cannot make any interference on the dependent variable or any influence contribution to the dependent variable. So variable are of other types also, instead of dependent and on independent variable, like extraneous, as I have mentioned. And another variable is also their confounding variable, but rest of these two variables we'll discuss later. But in this lecture we will try to understand the dependent and independent variables. So how to control, what is the experimental and control group? Listen, whenever we talk about the experimental method, there must be two groups. experimental group and control group. What does it mean by experimental group and control group? An experimental group is a group in which members of the group are exposed to independent variable manipulation. It means in the experimental group, variable will be manipulated, like a researcher want to study the role of temperature on the performance. Then what will he do? He will manipulate the temperature of the room, and then he will try to understand, is there any effect of the temperature on the performance of participant or not. So manipulation of the temperature is a independent variable. Temperature is a independent variable, and researcher is manipulating to the independent variable. What to see? To see the performance level. Suppose he is interested to see, is there any difference between the low temperature and high temperature condition. So he will manipulate to the temperature to study the performance. The control group is a comparison group that is treated in every way like the experimental group, except that the manipulated variable is absent in it. It means in the control group there will be no manipulation in the independent variable. They will not face any manipulation in the independent variable. For example, let's see. Now, question is, how to control? What to do so that we can eliminate, we can reduce the effect of extraneous variable so that we can conduct our researches in a very peaceful and noise-free environment. What can we do? So there are four techniques to control the other variables except independent variable. First one is organismic variable. What are the organismic variables? Such as anxiety, intelligence, personality, fear, motivation, background variables, and rural or urban variables, or you can also include the socio-economic status. So what can do the researcher to reduce them? Researcher can do that, he can match. What does it mean by match? He can select only those individuals who are almost similar in these particular characteristics, like anxiety, personality, motivation, socioeconomic status. So he will try to match, and he will try to reduce by matching. What to reduce? Organismic variable, in which he is not interested to study. And another technique, another technique is situational or environmental condition. So suppose there is too much humidity in the environment. You can see in this video which I am facing. So like these situation, experimenter can control. Suppose temperature can be controlled by the conducting an experiment in the air conditioned room. Noise and other voices, sounds in which a researcher is not interested to measure, can be controlled by conducting an experiment in the soundproof room. So these are the situational or environmental factors which can influence to the participant and the result also. So, and third point is sequential variable. What is sequential variable? Suppose a participant is coming from a long distance, and he is feeling experiencing tiredness, and at the same time you are asking him or her to participate in a study, the result of that study must influence by his tiredness. So what can a researcher do? Researcher can do by can do that he can reduce the sequential variable by providing a proper rest to the participant. Proper. And fourth point is random assignment. This is the very important technique to reduce the extraneous variable in any experiment. So whatever participant are there, whoever participant are there, can be assigned in the both groups, like experimental and experimental and control group, by random technique. There should not be any partiality, or there should be 100% chance of every individual to be selected one of the two groups, either in the experimental group or in the control group. So by following these four techniques, researcher can reduce the influence of extraneous variable in which he is not interested to study. So next, what is the limitation of the experimental method? There are some limitation of the experimental method. Before limitation, first statement I would like to share is that the strength of a well-designed experiment is that it can be provide relatively a convincing evidence of cause and effect relationship between two or more variables. However, experiments are often conducted in a highly controlled condition. This is the limitation. Because of experiment conducting in the highly controlled condition, the validity of, you can say, external validity will reduce there. Because if you will go outside to study, but in the laboratory experiment, we control all those experiment independent variables or extraneous variables in which we are not interested to study. But outside the laboratory, we cannot do the same. So in case of the validity, or especially you can say external validity, experimental group has limitation. We cannot generalize that particular experiment to all the population, because that experiment was conducted in a highly controlled condition. Second limitation is that laboratory experiment is that it is not always feasible to study a particular problem experimentally. For example, an experiment to study the effect of nutritional deficiency on intelligence. So can we do in the laboratory? Because that is unethical. If you are doing that, you are having a participant hungry for a long time or thirsty for a long time, that will be unethical. So that kind of study we cannot do in the laboratory, and we cannot apply the experimental method. Because if we are interested to see the role of nutritional deficiency on the intelligence, we have to starve some participant so that afterward we can measure the deficiency, role of deficiency of the nutrients. Another point is that difficult to know and control all the relevant variables. Relevant variables means extraneous variable is there. So it is also very difficult to measure and to identify the extraneous variable in the laboratory setting, that what kind of variable can influence the performance of participant, or you can say can influence to the dependent variable. So one another experiment is also there to overcome the generalization and limitation of the external validity. Somewhat we can enhance our external validity by experiment method, but there will be slightly different. We can say Cauchy experiment. What is the Cauchy experiment? Many variables cannot be manipulated in the laboratory setting, as we have discussed. For example, if you want to study the effect of earthquake on children who lost their parents, then what we'll do? We will decide, or researcher will decide, one experimental group and one another control group. And who will be in the experimental group? In the experimental group, those children will be there who have lost their parents, and simultaneously he has also faced earthquake. But in case of control group, only those children will be there who has faced the earthquake while did not lost their parents. So in such type of experiment, the independent variable is selected rather than manipulated. There is no manipulation regarding the loss of parent, because there is already exist group, like those children who has lost their parents and those children who has not lost their parent. So there is no role of the manipulation. So in that case, researcher can study the role of earthquake as well as loss of the parents on the children's, we can say, mental health or their well-being itself. Next point is, what is the non-experimental method? As we have discussed different type of variables in the experimental method, groups like experimental group and control group in the experimental method, manipulation in the experimental method, control in the experimental method. But in the non-experimental method, research is the label given to a study when a researcher cannot control, manipulate variable or subject, but instead relies on the interpretation, observation or interaction to come to a conclusion. Instead of manipulation, instead of experimental and control group, instead of randomization, instead of elimination of extraneous variable, non-experimental method relies on the interpretation, observation of the situation, we can say. So there is a very big difference between these both groups, experimental and non-experimental group. We can say experimental group is completely conducted in the control condition, while non-experimental group has no control over the independent, dependent or extraneous variable. So what are the highlights of the differences? Highlights of the differences can be discussed in 6 points. First one is, experimental group, if we are talking about the experimental group, there must be two kinds of variables. One will be dependent variable and another will be independent variable. And as we know that independent variable and dependent variable, what are the nature of the dependent and independent variable? Dependent variable is that variable which get influenced, while independent variable is that which influence to the dependent variable. Like we can take an example here. Suppose someone is stuck in the fever, then what will be the dependent and independent variable? To overcome that particular situation, which is the fever, what he'll be do? He will take medicine. And in that case, medicine is a independent variable, while fever is a dependent variable. Because fever is depend on the medicine. Another point is, for the non-experimental method, there will not be any category of the variable, variety of the variable. There will be only variable phenomena which experimental will measure. Second point is, for the experimental method has two groups, like experimental group and control group. While in case of non-experimental method, there is no such type of categorization, or there is no such type of groups. Third point is manipulation of the variable in case of experimental method. It means experimental method has some kind of manipulation on the independent variable, while in case of non-experimental method, there is no manipulation. Fourth point, random selection of the participant. In the experimental method, researchers assign participant randomly to the different groups, like experimental and control group. While in case of non-experimental method, there is no randomization. There is no random distribution of the participant. Fifth point is, in the experimental method, control of the extraneous variable. In the laboratory, when a researcher conducted a study, he tried to control extraneous variable in which he is not interested to study, like noise, temperature, humidity, he can control. But in case of non-experimental method, there is no control on the variable. And sixth point, low external validity. Because of highly controlled condition in the experimental method, there is very low external validity. We can say, we cannot generalize that particular study all over the world or other groups also in the same geographical area, because that study was conducted in a highly controlled condition. That is why we cannot generalize to all the genders or age groups or other geographical areas as well. While in case of non-experimental method, comparatively to the experimental method, non-experimental method has high external validity. I am using word comparatively. Okay, so these are the points which exhibit the differences between the experimental and non-experimental method. So these are the all about the differences between these two groups. Thank you so much. If you have any question, you can put up your question in the interactive session.